seen a lot of football, but nah, as good as this since I've been born, so yeah, it's really good.
Mr. Haaland is off, so yeah. Hopefully that gives us a good fighting chance.
It's my first Scotland game and hopefully we can convert this game to a win.
This is my first game as well, so hopefully it'll be ended on a brilliant result.
Shame Haaland's not playing, would have been great to see a world-class player like Haaland, but I'm still going to go for a fancy 2-0 win.
Aye, 2-0 tonight, I think.
3-1? No, yeah.
Should win this game. 3-1, hopefully.
I think it's going to be 1-0, Scotland.
2-0 Scotland tonight.
Yeah.
Aye, comfortably.
We might win, we might lose, but it doesn't really matter because we're through anyway.
Always be Scottish and proud, eh?
Hello, yes, one last game in this magnificent campaign. Highlights and analysis of that coming up with these guys. So let's get to the action with your commentary team tonight, Leanne Crichton and Alistair Lament.
It's a night of celebration at Hampden, a night to acclaim a group of players who have become heroes to a nation and quite simply made it great to be a Scotland fan again. The only thing left for this squad to do is to end the campaign with a victory to put the icing on the qualification cake. And Steve Clarke has made four changes from the side that started in Georgia, with Stuart Armstrong starting for the first time since the opening qualifier against Cyprus, and Kenny McLean a first start of the whole campaign after both came on to good effect on Thursday. Jack Hendry comes into the back four, while Jacob Brown makes his first ever Scotland start. Porteous, Gilmore, Christie and Dykes are on the bench. Norway are without some key players, not least Erling Haaland and captain Martin Ødegaard. Their last qualifier ended in defeat by Spain. Five changes from that one, including a competitive debut in goal for Egil Selvik. Chris Iyer and Fredrik Bjorken come in at the back, while Aaron Dunham and Jorgen Larsen are in up front. Scotland know a victory by two goals or more will put them in pot two for next month's draw, for better or for worse. Norway can't even reach the playoffs, so only pride at stake for them.
Yeah, it's a poor decision in my opinion. Now, it doesn't matter whether it's the 89th minute of the game. It's a cynical foul, it's a toe back of the shirt.
Nonetheless, it is time to celebrate. At Hampden, it is finished. Scotland 3. Norway 3.
I'm going to have a little chill out. Obviously, we've got the draw next month, so...
So, we had to settle for a draw. We had to settle for a draw, leaving us on 17 points and definitely very much off to Germany. It was just a strange game, as the guys were saying there, Neil. It was open, it was entertaining at times, but there was some good and there was some bad in the match tonight.
It was strange for us watching it as well. We were all laughing there and saying it's a wee bit boring, but it's a bad day when you're bored that we'll qualify for another Euros, you know, but already qualified for a tournament.
No, you never relax.
I know. I thought you were meaning about a tournament. I've never been.
No,
thanks for that.
Just in general life. Faddy, the first half was quite disappointing. Steve Clarke and John McGinn both referenced it there. How much of that is to do with the fact that we've already qualified? It's a difficult headspace to get into.
Yeah, it is. I think that, you know, both referenced it, John McGinn and Steve Clarke, and that the build-up is different because, you know, for Steve Clarke, there's no fear of losing. John McGinn, you know, saying it's a strange atmosphere.
OK, thanks, guys. Before we go, here is what is coming up for you to enjoy across the BBC this week. SWPL highlights, Monday at 7 with Amy Canavan. Then it's the Scottish Cup, that should be a cracking game, Dunfermline against Raith, 7:30. View from the Terrace, Friday at 10:30. The results show will be here on Saturday with David Curry, that's on BBC One, 4:30. And the Premiership highlights will be here at the weekend. I shall be doing the Saturday night, Jonathan will be doing the Sunday evening. And that's it. Congratulations to the Scotland team. What a campaign it has been. And if you want to hear a wee bit more about it, Off the Ball is on your radio right now. Good night. I'm on top of the world. Hey.